I tend to let meetings sneak up on me, so I want to get alerts half an hour before a meeting in the app I spend a ton of time in, Slack. And since Google Calendar doesn't directly integrate with Slack, I'm going to show you how to connect Google Calendar to Slack with Zapier. In case this is the first time you've heard of Zapier, it's an app automation tool that helps you by connecting all your apps together with a few clicks. So first, let me create a test meeting in my calendar. We'll use this to set up our Zap, which is an automated workflow. Okay, we've got it. Now I just need to connect my Google Calendar and Slack accounts to Zapier and get this going. I'm connecting my GCal account now. We have links to our privacy and data policies in the description, but at Zapier, we use bank-level encryption to keep your account information safe. Okay, GCal's connected, let me test it. It's good, so we'll continue. This down caret you see means we need to pick our calendar from a list. And let's adjust the amount of time before the meeting we want to get an alert. I'll change this out to 30 minutes and save and continue. And now let's pick a sample meeting, the one I just created. This looks good, so we'll continue. We'll be sending a direct message in Slack to remind me of the meeting, so let's get Slack connected. This gives Zapier permission to create and send a message in Slack. Let's test to be safe and continue. We have another down caret, so let's check out this list. It's pretty long, so let's search for the user we want to send the DM to. Some information came in pre-populated. The event's name and the start time is already there in our message. But let's add the end time, too. To do that, we just click on this button and find the field we want. I'm adding the end time pretty to match the format of the start time. You don't have to name the bot, but I like to. And adding a bot icon gives it a little bit of personality too. We're good here, so let's continue. This is a preview of the message Zapier will send to Slack when I click the Send Test button. Now, when I click Test, we're actually going to do the action. So keep that in mind when you test your Zaps too. Zapier is actually making the action happen. Looks like a success, so let's check out Slack. And there's my message. Just like that, we connected Google Calendar to Slack. Now, half an hour before all my meetings, I'll get a message reminding me in Slack. To set this Zap up, I used a Zap template. They make it faster to create a workflow and come with the apps and actions all ready to go. If you create it on Create a Zap or your editor looks a little different than mine, don't worry, the principles here are all the same. To learn more about Zapier and to try out this Zap template and get even more resources, check out our description. We hope this helps you be more productive.